I'll be loving you always, with a love that's true.
Postcards from the Bottom, Whatever Happened to Jessica Lee Smith, and the Mad News Network. I'm going to be moving on to all the other news today. But I just wanted to say one thing that I was thinking about that's been mentioned to me several times since I came here. I started talking about, you know, very subtly I was talking about the Hermitage. I didn't know everything here. I thought I was going to offend people and I was going to hurt people's feelings. And when you're reading stuff that's in the paper, you know, obviously you shouldn't be thinking about that if you're trying to make a career out of it, about hurting people's feelings. But I do, because this is where I live, and I know there's so many good people here. The reason why I'm speaking so in detail about it and sounding so upset about it is because literally, in this case, every single person other than him has been hurt. There's nobody here that is connected to that man at all, or that the things that were happening. Everybody in that business, everybody associated with the Hermitage in any way, shape, or form is great. It's only the one man. So the reason why I came on here is because, you know, I've heard a lot of things. You hear all these things about Jim Barnes, you know, just, you know, word of mouth stuff that I wouldn't normally talk about hearing about people. But I just want to say this because of some one thing. So a lot of people said things like, oh, well, you shouldn't talk about Jim Barnes, you know, because he's like a mafia guy. Number one, he's not Italian. I'm not saying only Italian people are in the mob or that Italian people are in the mob, but he's not Italian, number one. I'm not sure what his background is, and it doesn't make a difference. Whether or not a person is associated with the mafia, this, that, and the other thing, if you're referring to the Italian mafia, the Italian mafia doesn't hurt women and children over some criminal. You know, they're on your side. If you ever hear those stories, it's always someone who's in that lifestyle, you know, for those people that are in the mafia, whatever their background is. But it's always the stereotype that it's the Italian guy. Now, you see, the guys, relatives that I have growing up that were said to be involved in that and all that, they would never hurt a woman or a child. It's not like, God forbid, the horrific thing that went down in Mexico. What a sick bastard. I hope he's dead. That's all I'm saying. And if he's not, somebody should go in there and shoot him. Like, where are all the vigilantes when you need them? But first, make him suffer. You know what I mean? He killed people's kids. This is so out of control. Thank God I'm not the judge or the policeman, because I wouldn't bring the guy in. I would just fucking shoot him where he stands. But that's not the point. I'm not a violent person. But, you know, never worry about, you know, when you're thinking about the mafia and this and that, even though it's, you know, many people say it doesn't exist anymore. It's not the way it was in the old time of people my grandfather's age. I'm not saying my grandfather. But, you know, they had respect. They had an honor code. I know it sounds crazy because you think, oh, they were people in that business were killing people. You know, there were people that were doing terrible things, you know. You know, there's something, now I'm not saying anything about that business or whatever it's called type of thing, but you know, there was a certain code that they did follow. You know, there was no women and children and innocent people. We shouldn't be able to hurt people or want to hurt people over, you know, freedom of speech. It is my right as a human being to freedom of speech, not to mention that that's my profession. The reason why I'm doing this here, number one, I love this area and it's amazing. And when I got here, I realized it's completely ignored. It's ignored. This is the greatest area. And, you know, it's sort of like the way I would describe it and, you know, the way I feel about this area plus Vermont in general and all the stuff I've been saying, and you might think I'm nuts to feel this way or to say these things or attach myself to Vermont in that way. You know, many people have said Bernie Sanders is the father of Vermont. I would like to put in an application to be the mother. You know why? Because a mother protects, and that's how I feel about this place. Now, what I wanted to say is, a lot of people have said, aren't you worried that you'll run into Jim Barnes, or aren't you worried that you'll run into Jim Barnes' wife? I have nothing against Jim Barnes or Jim Barnes' wife. Jim Barnes' wife, by the way, I really have nothing against. I heard she's a beautiful, wonderful person, okay? I have nothing to say about her at all, and I feel terrible for what she's going through. I've been there, okay? I don't know what he's like as a father. I'm sure he's a great this and that. But if Jim Barnes, I'm not afraid of that. I'm not afraid of somebody coming, of Jim Barnes walking right up to me and saying, what are you talking about me for? Hey, you better shut the fuck up. I invite Jim Barnes to a conversation. Why not talk? Well, why not let's talk? Let's talk and make everybody here. We don't have to do it in front of anybody. you know, I can ask you, well, we can talk about what were your intentions? What do you plan on doing? You know, I'm open to that. That I'm available for that. I'm not afraid of that. I would love that. And I think it would help the area. So no, I'm not afraid of Jim Barnes. And I'm not afraid Jim Barnes is going to try to assassinate me. You know, the people don't hurt people over things like that. Maybe they do now. People are going so crazy over these things in the country and politics and all that. But, you know, we need to be able to talk again. And if you're going to pillage a community that I love, you're going to hear about it. I'm not saying you didn't hear about it. This guy was so over the top. I'm not talking about this guy and that guy. You know, this guy says this one didn't pay him that one. I'm not going to get involved in all that. I'm going to stick with media. But this is so over the top, this story. And this character is almost like a bully, but a manipulating bully that did this to this town. And I basically want to say these words. I'm the mother. So if you plan on coming here and pillaging this town, you're going to have to deal with me. That's how I look at it. Because I do have a mouth. So unless you want to be proud of it and walk around owning it, don't do it to this town. Postcard from the bottom.